This computer terminal provides full access to the Elcar's computer net.
Hey guys, Elcar's ADV here today. Well, a lot of you guys have been asking, which do I like better, the FSE300r or the TSE250r? Because I own both. Well, I haven't been able to give a concrete answer until now. So this last weekend, I got to go on an amazing single track ride, and my buddy Bob brought out his TSE250r, and I got to ride them back to back. And well, stick around to the end to see all what I think about this difference between the two, which one I might like better. So here we go, epic battle, FSE300r versus TSE250r. All right, guys, see you on the trails.
Riding the TSE and FSE.
Oh,
nice. On a grass track. So, got to kind of compare the two a little bit, which is nice. I own the TSE as well. Throw so you know that, anyways. But, it's nice to be able to compare the two, like, side by side, you know? The TSE definitely feels more light and nimble. For sure. Just a two-stroke, you know? And most two-strokes are gonna feel that way anyways. So it's really no difference between any KTM two-stroke, four-stroke, or whatnot, so it's all gonna be the same. Two-strokes are always gonna be lighter, and they're always gonna always feel like they're more nimble. So the FSE definitely has more grunt and power throughout the RPM range. Just right off the bat, you got the grunt. You got that tractor ability. But throughout the RPM range, it definitely... power throughout the RPM range, for sure. However, the TSE, once you gotta ride it aggressively, like, it's not meant to just putt. And, you know, I guess that's like a lot of two strokes. So, the TSE is definitely, once you get on the pipe on that bike, the power is there. It's definitely, you know, so a lot of its usable powers higher up on the RPM range. So, the FS, or the TSE, you know, the both bikes are very, very linear feeling. Whoop. Oop. I want to go down that. both bikes are very linear feeling, but the FSE has more off the start punch. But where the TSE shines is how light and nimble it feels. And this is no slouch either. And this feels pretty light and nimble too. But the TSE, this feels more so. So yeah. Both bikes handle very well. But the TSE is definitely meant to be ridden more aggressively. I think the FSE, you could definitely just chug along a little more, you know? Which one do I like better? That's a hard question to really answer, just because they're both great engines in their own right, you know, they really are. I've ridden the TSE and on the trails of Utah, and it's freaking awesome. TSE can handle anything you throw at it, really. But both bikes handle very similar, you know. So I think, as I said before in other videos, I think if I was a more technical enduro, I might prefer the TSE. Hard to say which one is. I don't think one is necessarily better than the other. As I said though, I think the FSE has more usable power throughout the RPM range. Very capable bikes, you know. If whatever one you chose would be fine, you'd be happy with it. It's not like if you bought one or the other you'd make the mistake, you know. But gee, if I could only have one, I don't don't know. It's a tough one, because I really do enjoy the TSE's engine. I think it's the two-stroke engine. It's just peppy, and I love running, going on the pipe, and it's a very peppy engine. Oh, plus I like the smell of two-strokes, too. Yep, yep. Boy, you know, without, you know, a crap load of hours on the FSE, I mean, I have way more time on the TSE than this. But if I had to choose one over the other, that's a toughie. Maybe at this point, I might choose the FSE. And I guess one of the, or two of the reasons is, is, like I said, the usable power throughout the RPM range. I think that's nice. Of course, a lot of that you can mitigate by good clutch control. But another reason is, range, fuel range. So, a longer ride, you're gonna have to be worrying about fuel. Whereas this, you know, I don't know how many miles you get on a tank, but I'm sure it's over 100. But she's really good at gas mileage. I did a test the other day, it was over 45 miles to the gallon, so that's with trail riding and stuff. So, you know, that's kind of a big deal. You know, you got a really long ride, you know, sets your mind at ease. And knowing you know, you're not going to be hurting on fuel. I had to choose one at this point without a crap load of hours on the FSE so far, I might choose the FSE. The fuel injection is nice. It's, you know, if you're traveling, if you travel, it'd be nice for it to not have to rejet and stuff, but honestly, I don't care a ton about fuel injection. Yeah, it's convenient, but carburetors are pretty easy to work on. There's no electronics or nothing, so that could be a pro or a con depending how you look at it. I tend to view the electronics as a con, but it is convenient. No rejetting. Like when I went out to Utah, I didn't rejet, and it was bogging pretty good, you know, so, or the TSE was. So fuel injection would have been nice there, you know, for traveling and stuff. So far, really liking this FSE300 engine, man. It's just a perfect engine. I rode a an FE350 at Varna, you know. I didn't think the engine was that much better, if it was better even. I don't remember being a powerhouse. So this engine is not a wheelie machine. I mean, it will do wheelies for sure, but you know, you just gotta work at it a little harder. It'll pop up though. Oh, took a stick leg there. Yeah, it'll do wheelies for sure, but not as easy as a, you know, 300 XCW or something. Engine, and it's just a great engine, perfect displacement, you know, where you start getting the 450s, you know, for trails like this, I think a 450 would be too much. You know, they're heavier and stuff, so 450s have their place. I just think it's just a perfect displacement. I really do. And it's like the holy grail of displacement. I mean, this is the engine that all those Hondas and Kawasaki's and all those crappy dual sport bikes that the Japanese are making should have in their bikes. Yeah, I really, really enjoying this engine. So, some of the awesomest trails I've ever ridden. So yeah, whatever bike you choose is gonna be good. All right, Elkhart's EDV signing out. Live long and ride.